welcome everyone to yet another edition of Expressions for the New Indian Express. Today we have with us the very interesting, always controversial and always news-making Governor of West Bengal, Your Excellency. Welcome. But first, of course, our sympathies for the state of West Bengal for the destruction that has been caused by Amphan. Tell us, Your Excellency, how are things there now?
First, let me tell you, and this is a gather from Mr. Chawla.
Yeah.
First, the ethics.
Right.
Let us never forget that.
Yeah.
I know it out of experience, and I've gathered it from friends.
Right.
And let me avail the opportunity to express greetings of Eid to everyone in the country.
Thank you so much.
Where we learn how to serve those who are in need. The state of West Bengal is in the crossfire both of COVID-19 and Amphan.
Yeah.
And the state is heavily stressed. On both the counts, we are in great difficulty. Things are picking up on COVID-19 front. The government of late is playing with the state back, and that is after the central team has come here, which is a good thing. There is a light of hope in the dark tunnel after the Prime Minister's visit. The Honorable Chief Minister was also there for aerial view.
Yes.
So that's working in togetherness. Cooperative federalism is being seen in the state of West Bengal at the moment.
But sir, you've been a big critic of the Chief Minister, especially on Twitter. You have accused her of hiding data on COVID. You have accused her of delaying the request for army help. Why is that, sir? You have quite a confrontationist relationship with her.
No, let me tell you. I am critic of none.
Okay.
I believe in constitutionalism.
Yes.
I take counsel from everyone.
Yeah.
I take command only from the Indian Constitution. Chief Minister is a nice person. My only problem is, I want Chief Minister not to have constitutional distancing from me. We welcome social distancing in COVID-19. Constitutional distancing with the constitutional head is not contemplated by the Constitution. My problem is that whenever a governor is appointed by a party at the center and there is a different flavor party in the state, then they think a rope is a snake. I have had heart-to-heart meeting Chawla ji with the Chief Minister on 3 occasions. I have conveyed her, tried to impress on her that you have a friend in Rajbhavan. He will never ever violate the Lakshman Rekha of Constitution. He will never take a command from Delhi. He will take a command from Constitution and his conscience. And the moment she feels I have overstepped my limits, she can call me at midnight. I would ever be in correctional board. I know Mr. Chawla is a very hard judge of events, but imagine the plight of a governor who for 9 months has not been briefed in accordance with the Constitution by the Chief Minister, in spite of numerous letters. I have invoked Article 167 that speaks duties of the Chief Minister towards the Governor. That has not been done. The good thing is, I want to leave the baggage of past behind. There is a big change I see in her in last 17 days. I am picking up the thread. I am trying to convince her things are brightening up. It will do very well for the state. It will do for the people of the state of West Bengal the moment we both are in the same page. I am committed to be the first servant of the people of the state. I am committed to stand shoulder to shoulder with her when it comes to the interest of the state. But so far, she has not indicated to me a single problem of the state with the center. And I have written communications to her on that effect. I am sure now she is trying to appreciate my stand. And things may look up. The first look up signal came when she joined the Prime Minister for aerial view. Can you imagine when we had COVID-19 situation? On 20th March, the entire nation was clapping to encourage the people, encourage those engaged in essential services, our health warriors, so that COVID-19 battle could be sharpened. She kept up. The government, on 5th April, we had a situation where lighting of diyas was there. It was to inspire people, motivate people. She kept me. I did not take ill of her. She did not greet me on my birthday. Honorable President was good enough to call. Honorable Vice President, Honorable Prime Minister, I took it in stride. That could be a personal decision. But now I want, and I see it, ice is melting. If ice is melting, it will be good for the people of the state of West Bengal. I take it as a great privilege for me that I happen to be the first governor of the state born in independent India. Having come to Kolkata, I have seen the best of heritage, the best of culture, the best of architecture, the elegance of the people, the high ethical standards, their interest. Trust me.
Governor Sahib, one question which I would like to ask you. You mentioned about constitution and you represent the constitutional authority. And that, you know, I want to know, you said one sentence which I couldn't interpret properly. Tell me if I'm wrong. You said she has not brought to you any problem which she can be taken to the center. Am I right?
Yes.
But do you think it's the job of the chief minister to go to the governor to reach the prime minister, or she can independently can reach the directly, because governor is not supposed to be the middleman?
Sir, you are right. It's a good question. Most people do not normally appreciate the role of the governor. They take the governor to be virtually someone who is ornamental. But if you examine the oath that I have taken, and my oath is very specific, Article 159, I have to protect and preserve Indian Constitution. That's the first part. The second part of my oath is, I have to serve the people of the state of West Bengal to the best of my capacity. Now the question arises, the Chief Minister, her oath is, she has to follow the Indian Constitution. So when, as elected Chief Minister, she took to the street on a law of the land that emanated from the Indian Parliament, I questioned her. I said, Madam, you are required to adhere to constitutional prescriptions as a constitutional head. A law emanating from Indian Parliament, sanctified by the President, that law cannot be challenged by you by being on a state. There is a remedy available under the Indian Constitution. If a state is agreed about a law, you can go to Supreme Court. I caution you.
Governor Sahib, are you saying that no chief minister has the right to protest against the policies of the centre by any method she or he chooses?
Sir, let me tell you, I concede immediately. Right to protest is fundamental to any democratic society. Right to protest is an expression of a point of view. Right to protest is the other point of view. More often than not, the other point of view may be the correct point of view. But if one is holding a constitutional position, if one has taken oath under the Indian Constitution, one has taken oath under the Indian Constitution that I will abide by the Indian Constitution, which means I will abide by the law that emanates under the Constitution. Now, if a law has emanated finally, which has taken the shape of a law, if the state government is agreed by that law, it has a remedy. Chief Minister has a remedy to go to the Supreme Court, challenge that law. But taking to the street by an elected representative holding constitutional position, in my humble view, is not acceptable.
Sir, I will ask again the same question. Are you saying if any law has been adopted by the Parliament of India, no chief minister of the country can go to the street and protest against it?
Sir, I hold that view. I hold that considered view. I hold that view for two reasons. One, that if you are on the street as chief minister, that is not permissible. And my stand is vindicated by the ruling party here. They wrote a letter to me that she is on street in agitation, not as chief minister, but as TNC. So from that point of view, I, Chawlaji, have got a great support from my chief minister in writing. The secretary general wrote to me that my stand is wrong. She is in agitation mode.
As party president.
Then I invited her attention again that you cannot wear two hats. The oath that you have taken under the Indian Constitution is not qualified, that this is subject to your role as TMC Supremo. That role capsizes the moment you take oath. For example, sir, I have taken an oath. Now, I cannot say that my oath is qualified by something else because I am associated with an organization. But there may be people having the other point of view. I hold this view after considering several situations and getting inputs from several legal luminaries that whether I am right or wrong. And all of them have given me one input. A constitutional prescription overrides every other concern. For example, in a passing way on CA, she said, we take it for referendum to United Nations. I took 3 seconds in reminding her, madam, don't do it. This is not good. This doesn't suit your stature. You are too senior a leader. Majority must emanate immediately. I am glad she undid it. So I am...
Sir, I am asking the second question. That you being a very active governor, I won't call anything else, you are a very active governor. Do you think it's the responsibility of the political party, BJP in the state, to rebut what she does politically? Why should governor take a political stand against a political opponent? After all, you are a nominee of the BJP government. And anybody you say as a governor will be same as a political intervention. So you have a constitutional authority. You can advise her whenever you want to advise. That's your prerogative. You have a constitutional authority. There's no question about it.
Sir, two things. First, I'm not acting governor. I firmly believe a governor is a happy governor, he is out of news. A governor is a very happy news in a happy situation if he is out of the media. I am in media because of the government. I did not close the gates of the assembly when I went there. It became news. But did I create it, sir? I had a right as head of the assembly to go there. The gate was locked. I did not create a scene when I went to Calcutta University and the gate of Vice Chancellor's office was locked. Sir, everything is created by the other side. But that is also my obligation. There are such scenes I must cut down, curtail. I have determined now that come what may, I will persuade, persevere, bring a situation that me and the Chief Minister are on the same page. She has to believe in me because she has to trust me. My bona fides, I will demonstrate when the time will come. The only guidance and script that I believe in is the Indian Constitution. I have slightly told her in light manner, madam, I act on the script of Constitution. You act on the script of someone else. You are too senior to act on the script of someone else. You cannot act on the script of someone else. You are a second term chief minister. You are a senior politician. And my chemistry with her one-to-one is fine. But the moment that one-to-one relationship goes, the stance is very different.
But sir, I'm you are saying,
may I ask a question here? Why does the governor have to then go on Twitter to announce all these things and to announce his differences of opinion with the chief minister? Why not pick up the phone and talk to her directly if your chemistry is so good, sir?
I have availed of all opportunities in speaking on phone, writing communications, sending informal messages. I have done it. For example, let me tell you something very serious. On Citizen Amendment Act, huge amount has been spent out of public exchequer. And the advertisements are for the party. I'm sure Mr. Chawla, with his huge background, knows that misutilization, diversion of public funds for such kind of situations can lead to disastrous consequences. First, I alerted informally. Secondly, I alerted telephonically. Third, I wrote a polite letter. No one had looked into the issue by then. And then when I formally wrote a letter, Others jumped into it. They went to the High Court. High Court intervened. High Court directed the state government remove from all platforms of these acts. The matter is sub judice. I don't want to say more. But I am indicating this only that I do not jump into reaction at all. I wait minimum 4 days before reacting. I wish because if something emanates against me, I would digest it, perhaps thinking in the good hope the state will withdraw it. For example, Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Ann Yojana is a scheme that for COVID gives for 3 months free rice, free ration, 5 kg rice per person per month, 1 kg dal per family per month. When it did not pick up, I persuaded the government, they took some weeks, ultimately it is getting. I get input from FCI, Chawlaji, written input that we have given about 5 lakh tons of rice to the state of West Bengal. I get input from NAFED in writing. And I find a minister of the government going at large. That the governor has moved his head.
Governor sahab, if I look at your statement, which are true, I hope, and that she claimed that she was giving 5 kg rice already before that. That's a different issue. But what you are saying that almost it looks like you, I said active, then now it is proven that you are active. Because is it the job of a governor or the cabinet secretary sitting in central government saying that why you are not implementing our scheme? I am just raising this question. I don't know. Why should the governor tell everything to the chief minister?
Sir, I need your guidance. For example, first part is protect the constitution. Second part is serve the people of state of West Bengal. Now, either the framers of the Indian Constitution, I just use this expression, if I have to serve the people of the state of West Bengal, then I have to find a by medium. For example, let me tell you, sir, can you ever digest it? State of West Bengal has 17 lakh farmers. All over the country under PM Kisan, a farmer so far has got 10,000 rupees. All over the country. During COVID also, they got 2,000 rupees. In the early part of this year, they got 2,000. Now, 70 lakh farmers of the state of West Bengal have not been given 7,000 crores so far. Why? It is their entitlement. State government does not have to contribute a single paisa. Now, do you, sir, expect a governor to be fiddling in Rajbhavan, maintaining this infrastructure and being helpless? The 70 lakh farmers who on their own may not be able to speak, but they are not getting 7,000 crores. 7,000 crores is change their lifestyle.
That's supposed to be DDT, isn't it? That's not direct transfer through the government of India. The farmer's money goes directly into the bank account, isn't it?
No, it directly goes, sir, but with one rider. The list has to be given by the state. The state of West Bengal has not given that information to the central government. So these 70 lakh farmers are denied 7,000 crores. What's wrong enough to act under Article 159, serve the farmers by inviting attention of the government of the day? Why don't you send details to the central government? The money comes directly. Money doesn't carry any photograph either of the Prime Minister or anyone else. Money doesn't have your any involvement of the state government. Why should we not get it? Even during this present cyclone, farmers could have easily got relief. Some has been announced. But with respect to farmers in the state of West Bengal, for that data not being supplied. I'm a worried man. During COVID-19, Chawlaji, our health infrastructure no time. Why we didn't take Ayushman Bharat? I don't want to play politics. That's not my job at all. But if Ayushman Bharat had come, 60% would have been the central contribution. There would have been little growth for medical colleges, hospitals, clinics, pathological labs. That would have happened. We would have had paramedical people, trained, skilled people. They would have got employment. So all I am addressing is, if you talk about my tweets, sir, pick up any tweet. And if you will have reservation on that tweet, I would be happy to apologize. All my...
Governor sahab, I request you here, because you are making good points there that she is not implementing. I am raising a fundamental issue. You are always invoking this constitutional under 159. She has also taken an oath under the same constitution which you have taken. So, She also taken an oath to serve the constitution and follow the constitution. And she is also following the constitution according to her. The way you are saying everything, I think this is not the job of the governor. Generally, she feels, I'm not saying it is there or not, I'm not passing in judgment. The way you are saying that all political statements which you are making now, or no other governor is making, now. There are many other states which are not implementing Ayushman or whatever. And West Bengal is not as worse as many other states in the country about COVID. So these, your interventions are there that you are the most active governor who are speaking more like on behalf of a political party. That is the impression that party gets, and they get provoked. They attack you after that.
Sir, I need support of media on this point. Judge me harshly. Hang me if I am wrong. If the governor's vehicle is stopped on road after clearance being given by the state security, on two occasions, and administration does nothing, can anyone approve it? No case registered, no police official visited with consequences. If I don't call it a breakdown of law and order system, what do I do? Number one. Number two, we have to give delete to the Nobel laureate. The function was outside dynasty. State had organized it. I couldn't hand over the degree. It was my choice. I may not have signed it. I may not have filed it being given. It was all with me. The Nobel laureate was in that room. His mother was there. I thought for a moment that there are so many people judging me all over, you being one of them, that you could have taken a path to facilitate it. I looked in the eyes of the Nobel laureate. I said, I'm signing it here and there. A photograph was taken. Then the vice chancellor came, sir, you have to authorize. I said, I hereby authorize. In serious matters, I have not crawled. I have bent enough. I will bend more. I will persuade. I will persevere. But sir, surely nobody would want a constitutional head to be spineless. I know role of chief minister is much more than my role. She is the executive head. She is elected. She is accountable to the people. But her accountability to the constitution is to be slightly brought to her notice and attention by me. And that's what I'm doing. But I'm now optimistic. I'm ever optimistic. I'm sure things will change. They are looking up. And she is. Go ahead.
Yes, may I ask a question here, sir? The fact is that things, you said that the ice is melting. But first of all, we want to know how do you judge that? And it's a good thing if it is. But sir, things are only going to get politically more active in the next few months, right? With the elections around the corner. And the relationship between the ruling party and the TMC, we know, is very bitter. So don't you see that your interventions or your active role is only going to get more demanding? It's going to increase?
Ji, let me tell you, with each passing day, Mamta ji will carefully appreciate all I have said. That in Raj Bhavan, there is a friend of the Chief Minister. In Raj Bhavan, there is a person who is bound only by the Constitution. In Raj Bhavan, there is a person who will take command from none. I know the importance of the word command from none. I will take my counsel only from the Indian Constitution. And I am sure she will rise. In my meetings, I have called her my sister. If I call someone a sister, can I go to that low level that I will act contrary to that? I will act only in accordance with law. All my suggestions are for her strengthening. If I keep on telling her, put the figure right, some people have said it amiss. Our loss because of this cyclone, maybe 1 lakh crore, maybe more than 1 lakh crore. I only suggested to her, let us confine to the real-time figure so that we can defend the figure, we can vigorously pursue our demands. On COVID-19, she took it otherwise. I said the whole world is laughing at us. Why are we fudging figures? Corona virus is a secular virus. It is non-discriminatory, not attached to any ideology, not invited by you or anyone else in the country. Why don't we reveal the real picture?
saying, Governor Sahab, are you saying that
and she's a gainer. Now our data, Chawla ji, of COVID-19 carries some credibility. Earlier they did not.
Is she fudging the figures, are you saying?
No. Initially, our figures were commented adversely by 8 medical associations, by doctors from state of West Bengal, located in the US, whose families are in West Bengal. They wrote a communication to her. Those figures were absolutely very different. I don't want to go into that chapter now, because we have had a long exchange of long letters, and ultimately that letter situation is over. I indicated to her that we must reveal everything to the people. The moment we hide something, that will be terrible. And that continued for some time. It was defended, seriously defended. But ultimately what has happened? We are getting close to transparency. Our data is getting respectability. People are serious now, and we are doing it. Secondly, for example, if I raised an issue, I raised a very simple issue, that what has happened in Nizamuddin has shaken everyone. All over the country, it has a heavy impact, adverse impact. Therefore, we must, in the state of West Bengal, focus vigilantly on it. Our first reaction was to a journalist who asked the question, what is about Nizamuddin fallout in West Bengal? She said, don't ask communal questions. She should not have done it. Now, point is, she is such a powerful leader that perhaps the only one who can convey to her frankly is the governor. Everyone else around is not picking up courage to show the real-time picture to madam. And
I'll just ask you, because earlier in the day and during the discussion you said that I will not accept anybody acting on the script written by outsiders. Do you think that Mamata Banerjee can act on the script written by an outsider? Who is that outsider you have think?
Sir, this is not a time we are in a difficult situation. But if two of you do not know who is the outsider, I blame my intellect. If this open secret, which is known to one and all, is not known to those for whom I have highest regard of investigative journalism, then that will be somewhat a difficult situation for me to digest.
No,
my only,
as far as I know, she is the only boss of herself. Nobody can dictate her.
Exactly.
So, let me tell you, sir, I have so much regard for her talent, so much regard for her, that she cannot act on the script of someone else except her own script. And if she acts on her own script, that will yield greater results than acting on somebody else's script. But that's a suggestion which I will give to her once we get a little more normal.
But as you said, sir, the ice is melting. What is your definition of this melting ice? Did you have a good conversation with her and the Prime Minister when you all went for the aerial view?
You see, that aerial view is a turnaround in the situation. It's a major milestone. It was perhaps, at least during my tenure, that she received the Prime Minister. Prime Minister had been earlier, she was not there. And her body language was very effective. After the Chief Secretary made the presentation, she took up and she highlighted 3 important issues before the state very forcefully, emphatically. And I have to tell her at one occasion, madam, you are a great articulation person. She said, Mr. Prime Minister, we are battling with COVID-19. We are battling with migrant laborers. And then this fury of nature has been unleashed. Our state is in difficulty. And the Prime Minister quickly said, all support will be given within policies. in tandem with the state government, and the state will get all the benefits central government can give, he will rise to the occasion. And I know he meant his words very carefully. He will live up to it. I'm sure about it. What I'm saying, something simple. Sir.
Governor Sahib, one question, if I ask you very frankly. Now, after snow has melted, according to you, what do you think her handling of the COVID and Amphan? How do you rate it? Is she good, bad, or whatnot? Are you satisfied with her now?
Sir, I would not like to be judgmental about it.
You have been judgmental.
Because ultimate judgment is of the people at large.
That will be decided at the election.
They will judge finally. On COVID-19, and it's not with respect to the state of West Bengal. For any state, if you look back, you can always say things could have been done differently. But what we have seen here is, we have had some very tough times. Very, very tough times, which I can't describe. No occasion to describe. We have had very tough times after cyclone also. Can you imagine the state of Kolkata not having electricity, internet connection, light, water, accessibility on road for more than 3 days? I think that should not have happened. The preparation should have been in place much earlier. If army could do something within 4 hours, surely if we knew about the cyclone, IMD had done a perfect job, our preparation should have been a little more. We have a huge contingent of public authorities. But if we end up saying that the government is not responsible for a particular public authority, then that escape route or finding an escape route cannot work. I suggest to everyone, ultimately the buck stops on the table of Madam Chief Minister. Every agency working in Bengal is accountable to her.
Sir, the question is, I read in the newspaper today whether that is right or not. She said the army should have been sent earlier. Did she ask for it earlier?
No, she didn't. I'll tell you, sir. As governor, I did not have the counsel of the state government before the landfall of the cyclone. But then I knew the cyclone will have a landfall. I knew from the IMD. I talked to the deputy director, General Bandopadhyay. He briefed me very thoroughly that, sir, it will have a landfall on this date. So what do I do? I immediately get in touch with 4 agencies. Indian Coast Guard. I talked to the IG Indian Coast Guard. He assured me fully that there will be no death on the sea. He lived up to its challenge. There was no death on sea. He said, sir, there will be no damage to ships anchored. He looked for it. Then there was the issue of Sundarbans. I talked to the BSF ADG. I told him, sir, in Sundarbans, we don't have Indian Coast Guard. He said, I'm looking to it. He did an excellent job. Then I got in touch with General Chauhan, Commander of Eastern Command. I said, General, what relief army can give us? Snika, army is fully prepared to give relief work. And then he explained to me in detail that our relief work will be in these columns. 11 columns are ready. Each column is of 60 people, 45 infantry, then engineering, etc., equipment. So that happened, sir. On their own, they were prepared. I knew the level of preparation. Now, if someone is prepared to help you out and you need that help, your people can do nothing at the moment because of several situations of lack of preparation, then why delay it by 3 days? That's a simple issue. It's not.
I have not got the answer. Did she ask for army in advance or not? As I read in the newspapers today.
No, I gather from reports that she asked for it. She asked for it. It was given immediately. As per the newspaper reports here, the moment she wrote to the Home Ministry, she got it. There was no delay.
So my question here is, my additional question, that shouldn't the first phone call in all these calls have been, with due respect, to the Chief Minister?
Madam, you can take it from me. I don't want to reveal what I discussed with the Chief Minister.
Yeah.
But nothing was left working at my table. I don't want to make a claim on television. I have never revealed my correspondence with the Honorable Chief Minister till she chose to go public with it on one aspect only. I don't reveal. I have respect for her. I have respect for her chair. But I have left no option without being exercised by me. I have not. And why I do it, I am doing it with a pure heart.
Sir, how many letters have you written to her, sir, during the past couple of years you have been there? You have been there for almost how many? 2 years now?
Sir, I don't reveal what I write to the Honorable Chief Minister or what she writes to me.
Only the number of letters.
Number of letters.
Just the number of letters, sir.
No, that will be unfair to her and her office, both. But one thing I can tell you. I have confined 100% to the bounds of Constitution. I have been very patient. I have not sent a communication for drop of a hat. I have sent communications only after I have not got the input available. Let me tell you for a simple thing. Rules of business travelogy require any communication from Delhi, which is shown to the Chief Minister, has to be shown to me. In 9 months, none has been shown to me. There is a written rule under Article 166.3. You have a great legal talent in the family. You can be wisened by that also. 166.3 rules of business prescribe any communication from Delhi or to Delhi has to be shown to the Chief Minister and Governor simultaneously.
Yeah, may I ask one question, sir? Having observed the Prime Minister and the Chief Minister quite closely in what you say was the major milestone, you also described her body language of the Chief Minister being quite different. Do you see a change in that very bitter relationship, at least to the public so far? It has seemed a very bitter relationship between the Prime Minister and the Chief Minister.
All I can say is, people were very happy that we all three went for aerial survey. People of the state do not want fight between center and state. People of the state do not want any fight between governor and chief minister. It is no good reflection either on chief minister or governor that people think they are fighting with each other. We all are part of this nation. Our sole motto and objective is to serve the people at large. Presently in the state of West Bengal, the people are heavily stressed. They are stressed as never before in recent times. Therefore, the challenge is Himalayan, a huge. It's a Herculean task. And in performance of that task, let us not think of 100% efficiency, but we expect that everyone concerned must be acting in mission mode without let up, so that some relief can be given to the people and they don't suffer. All I want is, and I'm a strong votary of it, that when devastation of this scale takes place, when hutmates Kachcha and Pakka are destroyed, when establishments go the wrong way, the relief must directly go to the beneficiary. If the relief does not fructify in reconstruction of the lost property, then that will send a very bad trend. And that will also account for good transparency, good accountability. Now, if I say so, and someone wants to see politics in it, I can do nothing about it. It is so easy to accuse a governor that since you are appointed by government in Delhi, therefore you are acting at the behest of government of Delhi. Let me tell you, and I'm telling on your screen, neither the Prime Minister, nor the Home Minister, nor any other minister has ever spoken to me about my relationship with the state government. Never issued any suggestion to me.
But they must be happy you are doing a good job on their behalf.
No, sir. I am doing a good job on behalf of the people of state of West Bengal.
No,
if I am focusing on that they must get free ration, it's doing a job for them. If I am fighting for the farmers that they should get 7,000 crores, I'm doing for the people of state of West Bengal. I'm doing it in favor of Mamata Banerjee.
Trust
me, the moment she gets the advantage of it.
I'll just saying that after listening to you for 45 minutes, I'm very impressed that there are two chief ministers in the state, one elected by the people of West Bengal, another by the center. And you are doing your independently good job, interfering where it is necessary for you, because you have given so many examples of what you have done. And I'm not saying you should not have done or done that for Hindu and the chief to decide. Does the constitution provide this kind of the governor will also perform indirectly the duties of the chief minister, where she or he is not doing?
I cannot pick up courage to say that this perception is 100% wrong because it comes from me. But she also said on two occasions, I am running a parallel government. Sir, if I was running a parallel government and you know me for some decades, can my vehicle be stopped on road?
That's wrong.
And if I am running a parallel government, can the gate of the industry be locked? Can the gate of the assembly be locked if I am running parallel government? If I am running the parallel government, can the chief minister or secretaries bypass rules of business? Sir, in all modesty, I say that cannot happen. Can anyone run parallel government of the Iron Lady? Amtaji is a very stupid administrator. One can run a parallel government only at a desire, whether it is taking place or not, or it is being done by someone else or not. I will not get into that area. There are certain open secrets on which I do not wish to reflect. All I am saying is, I have done nothing at all. Sir, if I was running parallel government, can you imagine it? A small thing. My discretionary allowance is cut 33% by year, lowest in the whole country, and I have no grievance.
Cost cutting.
I am only doing my duty, which is a difficult duty. I'll tell you why. And I have a suggestion. I don't put it grievance because media is too powerful. Sir, come to state of West Bengal, spend 7 days. Examine 7 parameters of governance and democratic fabric, and then I am sure you will leave for Delhi speechless without having an interview with the governor. You will accuse the governor of understating the case. You will tell the governor the situation was so explosive on several fronts, and you were still so heavily treated for the chief minister that you diluted it as a minor infraction.
I think you made a point. You invited me there. I'll definitely come when the COVID disappears from your state or from the country. I can't. Let me complete. What you have pointed out, there are 7 parameters you want me to judge the state government on. Are you saying, if I accept you and what you said and what I read in the newspaper and the BJP statement, if all of that is correct, don't you think there's a breakdown of law and order and constitutional mechanism in the state, and why don't you recommend 356?
Sir, I have told you, a friend of Mamtaji is in Raj Bhavan. I will never jump to that situation at all.
But trust me. You have made a case for that is not functioning as
no. Only with the pious hope things look up. Only with the pious hope. And some people are listening to it. You see, the purpose is...
You are saying there is no case for 3 intervention.
Sir, I didn't get it.
There is no case for 3...
I didn't get it.
I am saying that there is no case for 350, invoking 356 or 355 to give a notice you are not functioning according to the Constitution.
So there are 2 things. One, you know it more than I do. These issues cannot be discussed in public domain, number one. Number two, when it comes to performance of my duties, I will never fail. One, my duty is to work hardest to ensure constitutional prescriptions are not sacrificed and people are served. I'm happy to report to you that right now, situation is looking up. In the looking up situation, I do not want to carry the baggage of the past. I look forward to a bright future. I want to go to the end of the tunnel where there is enough light, where Mamtaji and myself, 1-to-1 becoming 11 and helping the people of the state. I am the last person to be ever concerned about the political scenario. And if I have best of friends in politics in the state of West Bengal, it is a Communist Party. They have been advising me, I've been talking to him regularly, very mature leadership, Congress leader of opposition, constantly in touch with me. Some from BJP also. I have talked at my own TMC president also. I have tried to reach out to everyone concerned. I'm in live contact sectorally, horizontally and vertically with the vice chancellor, servicemen, with anyone, only so that I can contribute wholesomely for betterment of the people of the state of West Bengal. I know it's a tough task, because if all my actions, all my visit to a place are seen with suspicious eyes, they are taken to be political in nature, I am fighting hard, because I have been advising the Honorable Chief Minister repeatedly, Madam, don't look through the political prism and don't look at the vote bank when it comes to development, when it comes to serving the people. When you are in political
Let me ask you concluding questions. How do you rate the performance of the government on a scale of 10? 5, 6, 1, 0 or what?
Sir, I'm sure nobody would expect me to be judgmental about it.
You have been...
But all I can say...
You are a constitutional... I'm an advocate. You have done very good practice in the court.
All I would say, sir, Mamtaji has enormous energy, a huge potential. The output, perhaps, is not consonant either with that experience, exposure or potential. And I am sure that is required. It's a huge exposure, huge experience, huge potential, but that has to be fully exploited. Somehow or the other, work in the direction so that her experience, exposure and potential are fully available for the benefit of the people of state of West Bengal. And I would urge you, can you give me a formula how to get Mamta from Mamtaji?
I think you can learn from your friend in the government. You learn from Arind Mohammad Khan, your friend from the Janata days, how he is conducting himself in the CPM run state.
During the 90s, he was my senior minister. I greeted him on it today and congratulated him that you are on a happy turf.
Both of you can exchange views
on how to handle
non-BJP government.
Non-BJP government.
Gona sahab, you are very experienced advocate and everything else. And wasn't one question which arisen out of your discussion, which was reflected in what Mr. Koshyari did in Maharashtra. You said your discretionary funds have been withdrawn. Mr. Koshyari says all the appointments in the governor's house should be decided by the governor himself and no interference from the state government. Do you think now governors are feeling under pressure that state governments are not letting them do what they want to do? Do you agree with Mr. Koshyari that all the governor-related appointments, selection, everything should be done by the governor? No interference of the state government.
Sir, two things. I don't focus beyond Bengal at all, number one. Number two, sir, I remember a great quote of Henry Kissinger. In diplomacy, if you win a point by argument, you lose the battle. My relationship with Mamtaji is diplomatic. I don't want to put it in argumentative shape. Otherwise, we both lose the battle. I am seeing a ray of hope. I am sure she has greater capacity to deliver. I am sure right now she is stressed because of several issues, COVID-19, the cyclone, the migrant laborers. She has those issues. But she is capable of springing into real action to take care of all these things. I only hope that she does it in the best way. And I want her to keep me in the loop. I made the suggestion about her only from that purpose, that if she had met me, I would have immediately indicated to her, Madam, the moment landfall in Calcutta is over, let us call the army. Next day morning, people would have seen roads being accessible and they would have applauded Mamtaji as never before, that our Chief Minister has done this. I am here, sir, to catalyze a favorable situation for the Chief Minister and government. I am here to crystallize a favorable outcome for people of state of West Bengal, and I will never miss that target. I will ever prosecute in that direction. Some people have been saying, I am battling with the Chief Minister, a very unfair comment. It is the other way around. I don't fight.
I think you didn't hear my question. I asked you. I think there's a link missing in that. I asked you, Mr. Koshyari had made a demand today that the...
I avoided that, sir. There are ways to avoid your protest.
You avoided that question. You're diplomatic there. You are not diplomat also.
No, you have protested for a long time, how to avoid a question. Sir, I'm avoiding the question. I said, I confine myself to only state of West Bengal.
I'm talking about governance power. I'm talking about governance power.
Sir, Mr. Koshyari brings on the table not the current office of governor, but also the Chief Minister. I have not had that benefit. We have governors both in Uttar Pradesh and Maharashtra who have the great asset of being Chief Ministers also.
I think you're getting enough experience of a Chief Minister also, the way you're conducting the
people. I wish it was not there.
People interest, and when you get back, hopefully, to active politics again, which is better for all of us.
I can assure you.
Getting more often talking to you at that time.
But I can assure you, I, even during that time, was a reluctant politician. Politics is not my cup of tea. And here also, my one-to-one relationship with the Chief Minister is so amazingly wholesome, positive, you cannot believe it. But something goes wrong when she follows some other script.
She may be upset that you see her TMC and she sees you as a BJP. There is a mindset problem, I think. This is what it looks like. Anyway, what I will ask, last question. Can you tell us what 2-3 advices you would like to give to the Chief Minister to make the state better governed?
Number one, sir, the Chief Minister is too senior, very experienced, has seen times. She is one politician in the country who is unparalleled. She has battled to destroy an ideology that was well entrenched for more than 3 decades. She did it under very difficult circumstances. She has held positions in the union government. She is the world's greatest street fighter, according to me. I would only appeal to her. She should not fight with me, because I am her friend. I believe in the constitution. And when the occasion will come, she will regret. Why did I fight this man who is so fair-minded, who is committed to constitution, who would get command from nobody? He will get command only from the Indian constitution. If I am saying on your television, and the kind of media you represent, and if I fail to live up to it, I know where I would land it. Sir, I will take command from no one except the Indian constitution. Mamtaji only has to believe in me. And I have nothing more to tell her except that I say so. And the moment she believes in it, we both will be on the same page, going in the right direction for the people of state of West Bengal.
Yes, thank you very much, Your Excellency. I do hope that you will now talk to her directly rather than on Twitter, and your conversations and your exchanges with her will be sweeter, as sweet as the state of West Bengal. And we wish you all the best. Thank you, Mr. Chawla. Thank you, Your Excellency.
Thank you, Governor Sahab. Thank you for accepting my
question. Kaveri's questions have been very sharp. Still, I don't go to the conclusion of their being gender biased.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Your Excellency.